So today I want to talk to you about accessibility widgets or overlays or whatever you want to call them that you have probably seen pop up in like a lot of ads on TV and like everywhere. I want to show you what they're about and how they don't help accessibility at all. Now let's get started about what accessibility overlays are. Accessibility overlays are buttons that you install on your website that supposedly are supposed to make your website accessible using just one line of code instead of paying a web accessibility team to audit and remedy your website. So one of the most famous accessibility widgets are AccessiBay, and there's also AudioEye. These are the most famous companies that provide accessibility widgets. So I'm in the AccessiBay's website right now, and if I go into the widget, it's usually like a button at the bottom of the site. So this is the icon for this widget. I click it and you're presented with like a lot of options. So you have seizure safe profile, vision impaired profile, you have cognitive disability profile, ADHD friendly. So basically the idea is, okay, if you are vision impaired, you click a button and then the website becomes accessible all of a sudden. There's also options for increasing the font size, highlighting links if they're not highlighted, to magnify text, to align it. Although I'm not sure how aligning the text on the right is going to make it easier to read, but sure, whatever. And there's also color adjustments. You know, if you want light contrast or dark contrast, you know, if you have a visual impairment. And that's pretty much it. Like if you go on a website and you have some sort of disability, basically you have to look for the widget and the widget is supposed to fix everything for you. Now this is AccessiBay, and AudioEye provides a similar widget. Again, it's at the bottom of the website, and it's the icon varies. Basically you click it and this one has a different UI, which this one is a little bit more difficult to use, I think, even though I don't use these widgets, because they don't really have text. There's just like you click next and like I'm already so confused as to what am I supposed to do. At least AccessiBay has some label, so I don't think this one is very accessible. So I don't know what
accessible label. Welcome to player. Continue listening to learn more about using.
See, I just clicked this button and I had no idea what was going to happen. And there's supposedly to be menus. Okay. So it just starts talking to you. This is really confusing. So this is very much what they are. These companies, AccessiBay and AudioEye, they try to scare customers, in my opinion, to say, oh, disabled people are out to get you, so you must install our widget and pay us $50 a month, and otherwise you'll get sued. And this is really, you know, they paint a really negative picture of disabled people, and they don't try to make the web accessible for all. They're just trying to, in my opinion, they're just trying to make money, and allegedly they have a lot of false statements. So you might be thinking, well, Stefany, if accessibility widgets are so easy to make websites accessible, why isn't everybody using them? Well, because they don't really help. If your website is written really bad and you as a company don't care about accessibility and disabled people, no widget is going to really help you, okay? I want to show you how bad those widgets are. I'm going to use AccessiBase widget and I'm going to increase the font size of the website. So I'm going to go to content scaling or font sizing. Let's go content scaling. Okay, so content scaling, this is just really confusing. This basically just makes the website zoomed in, which you don't need a widget to zoom in the site, okay? You can just use a browser. And that's another thing. A lot of these options, like you can use a browser or like a text magnifier. Every Windows have a screen magnifier installed, so I don't know what their deal is. But let's try to adjust the font sizing, okay? Let's say, for example, that I have forgotten my glasses and this font is difficult for me to read, so I want to adjust the font sizing. So I'm adjusting it to like 70%. And let's try adjusting more. As you can see, I have adjusted the font sizing to 190%, but because AccessiBase website is really badly coded, the text is overlapping and now the website is absolutely unusable if I require a bigger font, okay? So that's just one example of how bad this widget really is. And if I start scrolling, I can't read any of the text. So Those overlays are just ridiculous, and they, in my opinion, they just spread such falsehoods, and they're absolutely terrible. Another thing I want to share that I really don't like when they talk about WCAG compliance. Okay, the WCAG, you cannot comply to the WCAG because the WCAG is not a governing body. Okay, the WCAG is not the government. The ADA is a law. But the WCAG is not. You conform to the WCAG, you don't comply to it. Okay? If you run over a red light, you have broken a traffic law. So you must comply to the law. But if you run over a red light, for example, the WCAG cannot go and punish you for it. So they don't even have their wording correct. So they just makes me so mad. Another thing I want to mention is that the WCAG never says that an accessibility widget or an overlay is an accessible solution to make a website accessible. Nowhere do they say. The WCAG always suggests that you remedy your website with good, clean code and accessible code. They never, never mention an overlay or a widget. But on their website, there's always WCAG compliance. This is accessibility. If I
Accessible
go,
label, open intercom.
oh my God, this is terrible. How can I get rid of it? Okay, if I go to Audio Size website again, you. If I search for access WCAG compliance, okay, maybe okay compliance. There we go. WCAG compliance. That's not a thing. Okay. Anyways, so that's the gist of it about why they're so bad. I want to also show you an example. So there's the Benadryl's website that uses accessibility, and accessibility claims that their widget, if you just install it, no matter how crappy your website is, it's gonna be magically become accessible because why should you spend money on accessibility, right? So they're saying that their widget uses AI technology, which, by the way, AI is such a marketing trick. Nobody knows how AI works, okay? And nobody knows how machine learning really works. Like, of course, I know that AI and machine learning does work, and there are things that, does happen, but you cannot just get a piece of technology and slap AI and machine learning on it and expect, to do magic. But anyway, that's another topic. So they say that if you add accessibility to your site, it will add the alt text to images. Okay, so I went to Benadryl's website that uses accessibility, and let's look at what kind of alt text these Benadryl's website have on their social media icons, links at the bottom. Okay, so it says alt text missing. So we have accessibility installed, but yet those links don't have an alt text. So when the screen reader comes along these links, it's just going to read the links URL, which is really bad. Or it's going to ring the links URL, and it's going to ring the file name, read the file name of the image, which is also really bad. So the alt text is missing because in order for the alt text to be enabled, you actually have to go to the widget, scroll down, find the blind user setting, turn it on, and then the AI is going to add alt text. This is so terrible. What if a screen reader user, first of all, don't see it? Of course, they might not be able to see it. Let's say they're a sighted screen reader user, or they just don't detect it with their screen reader because it's in like a weird position in the DOM. But let's say that they do, and they have to read blind user. So basically, they have to admit to a machine that they're blind. It just makes also privacy concerns kind of. I know it's not collecting any information about the user, that's what they claim, but it's still very, awkward. So you have to turn it on. Then it enables alt. Let's see what the alt is for those links. White and black cross logo. That doesn't make any sense. Let's go to the Twitter link. White and pink heart illustration. This is absolutely false. YouTube. Okay, this is sort of like, right? Illustration, graphic design, and business. This widget cannot even generate a correct alt for social media icons, which is like the easiest thing you can do if you are like an AI. It is just so terrible. If it can do like the simplest thing to generate alt for, social media links, how is it going to make an accordion accessible, a data table, like a complicated flowchart? How is it going to make it accessible? It's terrible. I want to show you another thing. Also, another thing that's really bad with those accessibility widgets is they require JavaScript enabled. And I know 98% of internet users have JavaScript enabled, but still, an average of 1.3% of users don't have JavaScript. And if one of those 1.3% of users, some of them, of course, are disabled. So they're going to miss out on all of that I mean, not it's helping much, but if it requires JavaScript, a lot of those people are going to get left out. Because if I turn off JavaScript, the widget disappears. Another thing, ad blockers. Ad blockers hide those things. All of the ad blockers that I tested, they hide accessibility, they hide audio, they hide all the accessibility widgets. Whereas if you code your website from scratch, it's built in. So an ad blocker is not going to hide. And a lot of people use ad blockers because ads are pretty terrible. Another thing I want to show you is, let's go to Naturium Skincare. Now, this website uses a widget, an accessibility widget. Oops. This website uses an accessibility widget. However, it's funny because it uses an accessibility widget. However, I bet you cannot see it right now, but I'm going to show you where it is. It's in the left corner. However, the widget has the same color as the background, so it is barely visible. It's so terrible. This is accessibility widget this website uses. So if you have low vision, how are you supposed to see that absolutely totally unseeable icon? Like, my vision is okay and I still missed it like many times until I actually was like, oh my god, this is actually the widget that's supposed to help disabled people. You can't see it. So that's another thing with accessibility, which you actually have to find out. What about people with learning disabilities? What about them? Like, they didn't even think about them finding the actual widget. So, but of course, Naturium, they wanted to get the cheap way out, not actually pay people to make their website accessible. So, and not only that, a lot of accessibility advocates also have declared how useless those widgets are. So I have opened here the Twitter of Haben Germa. She's an incredible lawyer who happens to be deaf blind, and she says, as a blind person experienced with accessibility, I know not to trust this company. Now I'm sharing my experience with their work. Avoid AccessiBay. So this incredible lawyer who happens to be deafblind says that she just hates it and it's not helping at all. There is also Adrian Rosselli. He's a very famous accessibility specialist, and he wrote an article called AccessiBay Will Get You Sued. Because, yes, they say, allegedly they say that their widget is not going to get you sued, but you can still get sued even if you have a widget. Like, there's nothing stopping anybody to file a suit against you, at least in the United States. So that is absolutely false. And the same is with AudioEye. Although AudioEye also offer people to fix your site, but if their widget was working in the first place, why would they offer to fix your site? And why would they have a separate team that fixes your site? Anyways, I digress. Basically, widgets are terrible. Don't use them. They have terrible user experience. They're not accessible. The websites that sell those widgets are not accessible. I'm going to show you right now. I'm going to hover this and I'm going to press escape, and this hover over content doesn't disappear on escape, which violates a WCAG rule saying that content don't hover and don't focus, that is shown when you hover over a control, must be dismissible. So, and a lot of people use the escape key, and what they recommend is the escape key, but I'm pressing the escape key right now and this content is not dismissible. Not to mention, they have multiple accessibility violations on their website. For example, this auto rotates, which violates WCAG rule that says pause be added. So there's just many other accessibility issues, but I can make a whole video about it. But the point is, don't use accessibility widgets. So yeah, that was the video so far. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time.